Okay, good afternoon to everyone. So welcome to our science class. Okay, for today we are going to continue chapter 2. Chapter 2, 2.3. Okay, still chapter 2 ecosystem. So today we continue part 2, 2.3, interdependent and interaction among organism and between organism and the environment. So today we are going to learn about interaction between living organism. So we have three types of interaction between organism, which is a prey and predator, symbiosis and competition. Okay, for prey and predator, symbiosis, we have three types of symbiosis interaction, which is commensalism, mutualism and parasitism. And then we have competition. So all we are three types of interaction between living organism that we are going to learn today. So let's look what is prey and predator. Okay, prey and predator is a relationship where an animal capture and eat other animal. So we have a predator is an organism that kill and eats another organism. And we have a prey is the organism that is eaten. Okay, for example, here we have an eagle or hawk, burung, helang, memakan burung yang kecil. So the eagle is the predator. The small bird is the prey. So in this picture, the lion is the predator while the deer is the prey. So this is prey and predator relationship, or we can call it predation. Okay, boleh bagi contoh tak? Contoh lain. Prey and predator relationship. Ada nak jawab? Boleh on mic seorang-seorang.
Egg and eagle.
Yes. Bear and fish lagi?
Rat and owl.
Rat and owl. Tadi eagle dengan apa tadi? Snake. Snake and eagle. Itu contoh prey and predator. So yang dimakan tu adalah prey yang memakan
rat,
predator. Rat and?
Snake.
Rat and snake. Snake is a? Snake is a predator. Rat is a prey. Yes. So itu adalah prey and predator relationship. Okay. So kita tengok yang lain pula. So boleh faham kan prey and predator? Ni simple je, easy sangat. Okay, example tadi ada yang dah bagi. Snake is a predator, rat is a prey. Nampak yang dimakan, rat is a prey, the snake is predator. Okay, and then kita tengok pula what is symbiosis. Symbiosis happen between two or more different species which live together and interact with each other. So we have three type of symbiosis. We have commensalism, mutualism and parasitism. Okay, kita tengok dulu what is commensalism. Okay, commensalism is a relationship between two organisms which only benefit one organism without harming the others. So, bila ada dua binatang, two animals, one animal get benefit, the other one is not harming. Maksudnya dia tak dapat untung, tak rugi. Dia tak untung dan tak rugi. So, maksudnya dia tak ada kelebihan, tak efek apa-apa pada dia. So, this is commensalism relationship. So, kita tengok what is the example. So, we have remora fish and the shark. So, remora yang kecil ni. This is the shark. This is the remora fish. Okay, the remora fish, we call it the commensal. Sebab dia yang dapat kelebihan kat sini. So, it feed on the scrap of food left by the shark. So, bila ikan jerung ni makan, lebihan-lebihan makanan dari jerung ni akan dimakan oleh remora fish. So, dia dapat makanan dari lebihan makanan jerung. So, what is benefit for the shark? The shark is unharmed. Dia tak ada rugi, tak ada untung. So, this is commensalism interaction. Yang dapat untung remora fish, ikan jerung, tak rugi. Tak ada untung, tak ada rugi. So this is commensalism. Okay, contoh lain we have the staghorn fern grow on a tree. So this is help it easy obtain sunlight to process photosynthesis. Ini antara tumbuhan lah, tumbuhan paku langsuya ni. Staghorn ferns dengan pokok. So dia menumpang pada pokok untuk dapatkan sunlight, to obtain the sunlight to for photosynthesis process. Tapi pokok yang dia tumpang tu tak rugi apa-apa. Dia cuma tumpang saja untuk dapatkan cahaya matahari. Dia tak ambil nutrient dari pokok yang dia tumpang. So this is commensalism interaction. Antara pokok lain yang menumpang adalah the money plant, the pigeon orchid and the bird nest fern. So ini yang untung adalah pokok-pokok money plant, pigeon orchid, the bird nest fern and staghorn fern. Pokok yang dia tumpang tu tak untung dan tak rugi. So this is commensalism. Okay, katalah kalau pokok yang dia tumpang tu mati. Yang tu apa interaction dia? Kita panggil commensalism atau panggil lain? Ah, parasitism. Sebab pokok yang ditumpang tu mati. So itu kita tengok nanti. So ini one organism get benefit, another is do not harm. Kau kosong, tak ada efek apa-apa. Okay, interaction yang kedua, we have mutualism. Okay, mutualism is an interaction between two different organism that live together in which both benefit, both organism get benefit. So dua-dua organism tu untung. So they obtain nutrition and shelter from each other. So example, we have sea element. Ini yang panjang-panjang ni, sea element. And we have clownfish. Macam ikan Nemo ni, clownfish. So apa benefit untuk sea element? The sea element protect the clownfish from predators and supply food for it. The clownfish clean the sea element and provide nutrient to the sea element in the form of waste. So both organism get benefit. The sea element, dia melindungi clownfish. The clownfish pula bagi nutrient pada sea element. Okay, sea element ni a type of organism that is very poisonous. Dia ni berbisa, beracun. Bukan semua haiwan boleh masuk kat sini. Jadi clownfish ni dia boleh tahan dengan sea element. Bila dia menumpang untuk menyorok dari dia punya predators, dia bagi kebaikan pada sea element makanan. Dia dapat perlindungan dari predators. So both organism get benefit. So this is mutualism. Yes, mutualism. Okay, example 2 we have Egyptian proverbs and crocodile. Ini crocodile, ini Egyptian proverbs. So the Egyptian proverbs eat fleas and tick as well as food particles stuck between crocodile teeth. Dia makan sisa-sisa makanan dan juga kutu yang terlekat pada gigi crocodile. So the crocodile teeth get cleansed. So this is mutualism because the crocodile teeth get cleansed, the proverbs get food. So both organism get benefit. So example 3. Okay, example 3 we have lichen. What are lichen? Lichen are algae and fungi that live together. Dua-dua ni dia kita panggil lichen bila algae dengan fungi duduk sekali. They live together. So the fungi supply water and mineral to the algae. The algae carry out photosynthesis and supply food to the fungi. Sebab fungi ni sejenis kulat. Jadi dia tak boleh buat fotosintesis. So dia dapat dari mana makanan? Makanan dia dapat dari algae. So the algae buat fotosintesis, carry out fotosintesis and supply food to the fungi. Fungi pula bagi water and mineral to the algae. So both organism get benefit. Ini contoh lichen. Okay, example 4. We have myna and buffalo. So the myna ni burung tiung. So dia dapat makanan. The myna get food by eating the lice that stick to the body of the buffalo. The body of the buffalo is free of lice. Biasanya badan kerbau ni ada kutu. Kutu-kutu tu akan dimakan oleh burung tiung. So the myna get food, the buffalo body jadi bersih from the lice, free of lice. Jadi both organism get benefit. So this is mutualism. Okay, interaction yang ketiga, we have parasitism. So what is parasitism? Okay, parasitism is interaction between two organism that benefit one organism only and harm the other. Maksud dia satu organism sahaja yang untung, lagi satu rugi. Dia dapat negative effect ataupun sakit. So harm the other organism. So satu untung, satu rugi. This is parasitism. So kita tengok what is the example. So we have tapeworm ni cacing pita, tinggal dalam kita punya usus. Okay, the tapeworm is a parasite. It lives in human intestine. Di dalam usus ni gambar ni. So the tapeworm obtain foods and shelter from human. Human lost weight, weight and become weak. And jadi manusia dapat sakit, sakit perut sebab ada cacing dalam perut dia, dalam usus dia. So yang untung kat sini adalah tapeworm. So the tapeworm is we call it the parasite. The human intestine is the host, perumah. So one organism get benefit which is tapeworm. The human intestine, the human is harmful. Dia dapat sakit, kita dapat sakit and become weak because the parasite. So this is parasitism. Okay, ada contoh lain untuk parasite. Siapa boleh bagi?
Flea and human.
Okay, flea and human. Sama juga kutu. Contoh dia isap darah manusia. Manusia rugi. Okay, lice and human. Ada lagi contoh lain for parasitism? Okay, satu lagi we have Rafflesia flower, bunga Rafflesia dengan tumbuhan. Yang tu parasitism juga. Sebab bunga Rafflesia dia dia absorb all the nutrient from the plant. So the plant yang dia tumpang tu akan mati. So ini adalah parasitism. Okay. Competition. Direction yang ketiga. Tadi simbiosis kita ada tiga jenis kan? Mutualism, commensalism and parasitism. Sekarang interaction yang ketiga, competition. So, what is competition? Competition is a relationship where organism compete with each other for food, light, water, shelter, mate or mineral. Maksudnya, organism ni bersaing untuk mendapatkan makanan, cahaya matahari, air, tempat tinggal, pasangan dan juga mineral. Okay, contohnya kita ada haiwan, contoh gambar kat sini kita ada lion. Dia compete dengan rubah untuk dapatkan makanan. Dekat sini rusa ni dia compete for mate untuk pasangan. Tumbuh-tumbuhan ni compete for sunlight. Pokok yang lebih tinggi hidup. Mereka compete untuk dapatkan cahaya matahari. So the stronger organism are successful in controlling their territory. Weaker and smaller organism are driven out of the area. Maksudnya organism yang kuat dia berjaya untuk survive. Untuk yang lemah, dia akan terkeluarlah daripada kawasan tersebut ataupun dia akan mati. Okay, contoh kita ada flowering plants compete with weeds to obtain water and mineral salt. Yang ni untuk semua tumbuhan lah, tak semestinya flowering plant. Ni contoh saja. So a lion in a pride compete for food. Plant in a tropical rainforest compete for basic needs. Taller tree obtain sunlight more easily. Contoh dalam hutan, katulistiwa, rainforest, the taller tree obtain more sunlight. So that is the type of competition. Okay, intraspecific competition is competition among organism of the same species. Nampak ni, species yang sama. Serigala ni, the wolf. So kita panggil interspecific competition. Kalau species yang berbeza, kita panggil interspecific competition. So this is competition among different species. So kat sini you nampak ada lion, eagle. Ini apa ni? Maksudnya different species. So this is interspecific competition. Kalau intra, same species. Kalau inter, different species. Okay, summary untuk interaction tadi. So, type of interaction, we have competition. Species satu akan dapat untung, species yang kedua akan dapat rugilah sebab dia dimakan. Dia bersaing, yang kalah, yang lemah akan mati ataupun akan menjadi lemah. So, negatif. Prey and predator. The prey and predator. So, species satu predator akan dapat untung sebab dia dapat makanan. Prey or organism yang dimakan. So dia negatif. Dia rugi, dia mati. Parasitism. One species get benefit, another one die. So this is negatif. Satu untung, satu rugi, negatif. Commensalism. One species get benefit, another one is tak ada efek apa-apa. Tak rugi, tak untung. So kita tulis kosong. Ini commensalism. Kalau mutualism, both organism get benefit. So both species positif, untung. Kita tulis positif. One organism get benefit, another one for also get benefit. So, dua-dua untung. So, this is mutualism. So, ini yang tadi interaction yang kita dah belajar tadi. Kita ada competition, prey and predator. And then we have parasitism, commensalism and mutualism. Okay, tiga-tiga ni adalah symbiosis. A type of symbiosis process. Okay, setakat ni boleh faham tak interaction ni? Ada soalan tak nak tanya?
Tak
boleh. Tak boleh. So awak kena tahu competition, prey and predators. Lepas tu symbiosis ni ada tiga jenis. Kamu kena tahu bezakan. Kalau parasitism, satu organisma untung, satu rugi. Kalau commensalism, satu untung, satu tak ada efek apa-apa. Dia tak rugi, dia tak untung. Kalau mutualism, both organism get benefit. So dua-dua untung. Itu sebab tu kita tulis tambah-tambah. So mutualism, both organism get benefit. Okay, kita masuk sub topik yang baru, biological control. Okay, what is biological control? Okay, biological control is a method which predator is the natural enemy to a certain pest. So, it is used to control the population of the pest in an area. Okay, contoh. Dekat sawah padi, biasa petani dia ada masalah dengan tikus. Tikus akan makan padi, betul tak? Yeah. So, macam mana kita nak halau tikus tu selain daripada guna racun?
Panggil burung hantu.
Kita boleh. Bela burung hantu. The farmer will rare and old ataupun boleh letak kat ular ataupun burung hantu. Biasanya farmer akan letak burung hantu lah. So inilah kita panggil biological control. Kita gunakan kaedah kawalan biologi. Kita tak guna safe to the environment. Kita gunakan kaedah yang selamat. Maksudnya kita guna tadi, kita dah belajar dah interaction prey and predator. So kita gunakan dia punya predators. What is the predator of that prey? Okay, contoh kat sini kita ada aphid. Aphid is a pest. Ni serangga perosak. Kalau pekebun, dia akan makanlah tumbuh-tumbuhan sayur-sayuran tu. Jadi rugilah petani. Tapi petani tu dia tak nak guna pesticide. Sebab pesticide ni berbahaya, ada chemical. So dia nak guna kaedah biological control. Dia nak guna kaedah semula jadi. Jadi dia akan use the ladybird. So the ladybird help the gardener by ridding him of this pest. Dia akan bela ladybird sebab ladybird ni makan aphid tadi. So this is biological control. We use the predator to control the pest in that area. Okay, contoh lain. Macam tadi, Prasya ada bagi contoh tadi. Old, kita di ladang kelapa sawit. Old are kept in palm oil plantation to control the population of rat. Sebab burung hantu ni dia makan tikus. So we use old to eat the rat. And then we have Bacillus thuringiensis is used to control pests, namely rhinoceros beetle in the palm oil plantation. Okay, selain daripada masalah tikus dekat palm oil plantation, kita ada masalah kumbang ni, nampak? Rhinoceros beetle ni, dia juga serangga perosak dekat ladang kelapa sawit. Jadi, the farmer ataupun the owner akan gunakan Bacillus thuringiensis to get rid of the beetle. Okay, Bacillus contoh lain.
Cikgu, Bacillus ni dia jenis macam bakteria ke?
Dia macam bakteria, sejenis organism, macam bakteria.
Oh.
Okey, kemudian kita kalau dekat kolam, pond ecosystem, untuk kita gunakan gapi, ikan gapi to is the predator to mosquito larva in a pond. So dekat dalam kolam biasanya ada jentik-jentik kan, ada larva. Jadi tuan kolam ataupun the owner akan gunakan ikan gapi to get rid of the mosquito larva sebab ikan gapi ni akan makan larva. Okey, contoh lain tadi sama juga ladybird dengan aphid tadi, cikgu dah explain tadi. Okey, kemudian satu lagi, duck are red in the paddy field to eat the pests such as snail and insect. Okey, dekat sawah padi ada juga masalah siput, snail. So the snail is eaten by the duck. Jadi petani akan bela itik untuk supaya itik tu makan snail tadi. Snail is maksudnya dia makan tempat sawah padi dan kerosakkanlah, rugilah. Jadi petani akan bela itik supaya itik ni makan siput tadi. Ni this is biological control method. Okay, boleh ingat tak contoh ni? Contoh ni maksudnya kita gunakan prey and predator interaction lah. Predator akan makan prey. So this is biological control method. Ini contoh-contoh yang dekat Malaysia lah. Example of biological control in Malaysia. Okay, boleh faham tak ini?
Boleh.
Faham.
Faham. Okay, so kita tengok pula what is the advantages and disadvantages bila gunakan biological control. Okay, advantages dia is does not pollute the environment. It does not kill other organism except the pest. So, organism yang mati hanyalah pest sahaja, serangga perosak sahaja. Dia tak kacau serangga lain. Okay, it is cheap and safe to use. Dia murah dan juga selamat digunakan. Okay, ini dia punya advantages. What is the disadvantages? Okay, dia punya keburukan, disadvantages. It takes a long time before any effect is seen. And then the balance of the ecosystem might be disrupted. Sebab kita masukkan organisma lain. Organisma lain dalam sesuatu habitat. Jadi mungkin mengganggu keseimbangan ekosistem. Okay, it takes a long time before any effect is seen. Maksudnya lambatlah sebab kita guna kaedah semula jadi. Kalau guna pesticide, guna racun, sekejap dia dah mati haiwan-haiwan tadi. Tapi bila guna kaedah yang semula jadi ni, dia lambat sikitlah. It takes a long time before any effect is seen. Ini dia punya disadvantages. Biasa soalan akan tanyalah what is the advantages of biological control. So boleh bagilah one or two point here. And then boleh juga ditanya what is disadvantages of biological control. Okay, the disadvantages, it takes a long time before any effect is seen and the balance ecosystem might be disrupted because we add another organism into the habitat. Okay, sub topik yang terakhir untuk hari ni. Okay, what is the factor that influence population size in an ecosystem? Okay, sebelum ni kita dah tahu dah what is the definition of ecosystem. Jadi kita nak tahu apakah faktor ataukah what is the factor that influence population size in ecosystem. So ada banyak faktor, antaranya adalah disease, the presence of predators, the sources of food and the change of weather. Okay, kita tengok dari segi disease. Okay, population of animal and plant decrease when a disease strike. Example, poultry affected by disease. Contoh ternakan ayam ni. Biasa ada penyakit, bila ada penyakit, the population pun akan decrease. Bila ayam tu mati. Contoh, kalau ayam ni biasa penyakit kuku dan mulut. Jadi, bila ada penyakit datang, the size of population will decrease. Jadi, effect lah that population. Contoh pokok ni mungkin penyakit, nampak ni. Daun-daun dia kekurangan nutrisi, pokok tu akan mati. So, the size of population affected. Okay, the presence of predators. When the number of predators increase, the number of prey decrease. Jadi bila ada banyak predators, the prey will decrease. Sebab predator tadi akan makan prey. Jadi bilangan dia akan berkurangan. Okay, C. Sources of food. If the sources of food decrease, the animal can treated by extinction. Okay, sumber makanan. Katalah sumber makanan berkurangan pada sesuatu tempat, maka haiwan juga akan mengalami kepupusan. Sebab apa? Sebab dia akan mati sebab dia tak ada makanan. Sumber makanan tadi berkurangan. For example, here we have panda. Okay, dia punya sumber makanan. Dia punya hutan, pokok buluh. Sumber makanan dia terhad. Jadi dia juga boleh mengalami kepupusan. Kenapa sumber makanan dia tak ada? Sebab manusia tebang hutan. Bila tebang hutan, sumber makanan pun berkurangan. Sebab panda ni makan pokok-pokok buluh ni dari sumber hutan. So the animal can treated by extinction. Ini dari segi sources of food. Okay, change of weather. Kalau ada perubahan cuaca. Okay, drought cause soil to become dry and infertile and increase the risk of forest fire. Okay, contoh bila ada perubahan cuaca seperti kemarau, banjir, dia akan efek lah pada sesuatu ekosistem. Contohnya bila kemarau, tanah jadi kering, tumbuhan pun tak boleh hidup. Bila tumbuhan tak boleh hidup, jadi haiwan yang makan tumbuhan pun akan mati juga sebab mereka tak ada makanan. Sama juga kalau tiba-tiba banjir. Haiwan boleh mati disebabkan tak dapat selamatkan diri dari banjir. Okay, changes in ecosystem. The changes in ecosystem such as limited water supply, animal migration and increase or decrease in population can upset the balance between population. Okay, jadi bila ada perubahan dalam ekosistem disebabkan faktor-faktor tadi, dia akan mengubahlah keseimbangan population pun akan terjejas. Okay, so sebab apa boleh berlaku perubahan pada ekosistem? Because of limited water supply, because of animal migration and increase or decrease in population size can upset the balance between ecosystem. Disebabkan faktor-faktor tadi. Jadi dia akan mengubah ekosistem. Okay, setakat ni boleh?
Boleh.
Boleh tak? Ada soalan nak tanya?
Tak ada, cikgu.
Yang lain ada tak? Boleh type ataupun boleh cakap, boleh on mic sekejap. Okay, jadi hari ni, ni last slide untuk hari ni. So that's all for today. Don't forget to do your notes. Nota nanti cikgu akan bagi dalam Telegram slide untuk hari ni. Kemudian homework hari ni buat activity book page 20, 21 and 22. Okay, ada tak nak tanya soalan?
Ada cikgu, thank you untuk bagi kerja buku TV.
Ya, ada apa ni? Nadim. Nak tanya soalan apa? Cikgu hari-hari cantik. Okay, kalau tak ada apa-apa lagi, kita tamatkan kelas lah untuk hari ni. So, boleh buat nota dan juga buat buku aktiviti. Okay. Okay, till next class. See you.
Bye, cikgu. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, cikgu.
Welcome.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you, teacher.
Bye.
Thank you, teacher.
Bye.